प्लाज्मा कन्फाइनमेंट इज ए वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग प्रॉब्लम इन प्लाज्मा फिजिक्स. एक्चुअली व्हेन ए प्लाज्मा इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एन एक्सटर्नल और इंटरनल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड देन प्लाज्मा कन्फाइनमेंट टेक्स प्लेस. टुडे इन दिस रिगार्ड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेल्फ कन्फाइनमेंट ऑफ प्लाज्मा. व्हेन यू से सेल्फ कन्फाइनमेंट ऑफ प्लाज्मा इट मीन्स this is confinement of plasma by its own magnetic field, that is the magnetic field created by the plasma itself. And this self confinement of plasma is actually known as pinch effect. Here you may remember that this the word pinch does not mean name of a scientist, but it means a squeezing, or it is just a squeezing tendency. And so we will see why it is called pinch effect. So now let us start to discuss the self confinement of plasma, or the important phenomenon which is known as pinch effect. Actually, as I have told you, that pinch effect is the confinement of plasma by self magnetic field, that is the magnetic field which will be created or produced by the plasma itself. Actually, when a large current through an ionized gas creates a strong magnetic field, you know that current is a source of magnetic field, and if the current is large, then a strong magnetic field will be produced by it. And if this large current passes through an ionized gas, then a strong magnetic field is produced. And if the current flows in the cylindrical column, as we will see in the next page, there is a cylindrical column in which we have considered that the current is flowing. So if the current flows in the cylindrical column, the line of force, you know, form a concentric circles with the cylinder. There is a lateral repulsion between the lines, and that lateral repulsion actually exerts a pressure in radially inward direction. And due to this radially inward pressure, which is developed here due to the mutual repulsion between the concentric circle of line of force, actually the charge carrier experiences force in inward direction. And so due to this force, the charge carrier get compressed inwards. And in fact, this squeezing or pinching of the column of streaming particles of plasma is known as pinch effect. So you can see why this name is pinch effect, because there is just a squeezing of the streaming particles in inward direction, and so it is called pinch effect. Now we will actually discuss this pinch effect in analytically, and or you can say that we will give here a mathematical analysis of pinch effect. And for this mathematical analysis, let us consider, as I have told you, a cylindrical column in which we consider that the plasma fluid is flowing. And you may say that the plasma particle, that is the charged particles, are moving from left to right in this cylindrical column. And you know that when we consider a column of cylindrical symmetry of moving charged particle, then the streaming particle will constitute a current, and the current density which will be constituted by the streaming particle can be given as that the current density due to the streaming particles. Streaming particles. You have definitely studied it that this current density is given as J equal to rho into V. And in fact, in this equation, what is this rho? Rho is in fact volume charge density. Volume charge density. And V is the drift velocity. This is in fact drift velocity with which the particles are moving. So due to the streaming particle, a current is constituted, and the density of that current is given by this relation J equal to rho V. And you know that an electric current produces magnetic field. So due to this current produced by the streaming particle, a magnetic field will be produced. And according to the Fleming's left hand rule, or you can say according to the right hand screw rule, that the magnetic field produced will be actually surrounding the column of the cylinder. And so this is just an azimuthal magnetic field. You can see from this figure that this is actually the azimuthal magnetic field, which I have shown here by this circular loop, and this is produced by the current which is due to the streaming particle. And so the plasma particle, which is actually charged plasma particle, actually finds themselves in the magnetic field produced by this current. So if we consider, let B equal to magnetic field, actually this magnetic field will depend on distance, and this will be a function of R. So if B is the magnetic field produced by the current, and you know this current is produced by the streaming particle of plasma, then magnetic force on unit volume, you know what is the expression for magnetic force per unit volume. If we denote this force by F, then this F is actually given as what? This is J cross B. So you can see the streaming particle finds themselves in the magnetic field, and due to this magnetic field, which is already produced by the streaming particle, they experience a magnetic force. And this magnetic force acting on unit volume is given as J cross B. And in fact, this force J cross B is actually directed towards the axis of the cylindrical column. So if this is our cylinder, this force is directed in along this axis, and due to this force, the particle gets squeezed towards the axis. So this is the direction of the force. So this force, as I have told you, acts towards the center of the column or axis of the column, and due to this region, actually the column of the streaming particle gets squeezed or pinched, hence the name is pinch effect. So you can see that F is directed towards the center of the column. And so the streaming particles streaming particles experience force in radially inward direction. Radially inward direction, and hence the particles get squeezed or pinched. And this is why this phenomenon is known as pinch effect. Actually, now we will try to find what is the current needed for this pinch effect. And in this case, we will also calculate the expression for the pressure, which is actually called magnetic pressure, which is developed here, and that is responsible for this pinching or squeezing. So now our aim is to find the expression for the magnetic pressure, and after that we can calculate the value of the discharge current, which is actually needed for this. Actually, what I have told you, you can see in this figure, that here I have shown that the radius of this cylindrical column is capital R, and in fact this is here you can see that the streaming particle has been squeezed or pinched in the middle part. You can see from this figure, and this is actually the pinch effect, and this is due to the pressure developed, and that pressure acts toward the center of the column. So now let us try to find the expression for the pressure, which is actually called magnetic pressure, which is responsible for this squeezing or pinching. And after that, as I have told you, we will calculate the discharge current, which is actually needed for the pinch effect. And actually that current is also known as pinch current. You will see that this pinch current is of the order of 10 to the power 6 ampere, that is 1 million ampere. So this is actually a very high discharge current. But how you can say that this much current is needed for this purpose, we will now see it mathematically, and we will calculate it in analytical manner. Actually, the streaming particles can also be called a high current discharge through the plasma. And from Ampere's circuital law, we can find the magnetic field at a distance r from the axis of the discharge. So applying the Ampere circuital law, we can perform this calculation, which we need to calculate the magnetic pressure and the discharge current. So you can see from Ampere circuital law, from Ampere's circuital law, the magnetic field at a distance r from the axis of the discharge is given as, in fact, in integral form we write the Ampere circuital law for finding this magnetic field, and this is given as mu naught over r. Mu naught is permeability of the free space. Integral 0 to r जे ऑफ आर प्राइम डी आर प्राइम. दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एट ए डिस्टेंस आर फ्रॉम द एक्सिस ऑफ द डिस्चार्ज इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द एम्पियर सर्क्यूटल लॉ. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस रिजल्ट वी कैन फाइंड द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विथ द डिस्टेंस आर. सो नाउ यू कैन फाइंड डेल बी ऑफ आर बाय डेल आर. यू कैन सी दिस एक्सप्रेशन एंड लेट अस डिफरेंशिएट इट पार्शियली विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आर. सो यू कैन सी हियर देयर इज जस्ट म्यू नॉट इज जस्ट ए कॉन्स्टेंट फैक्टर and 1 over r is one function and another function is integral 0 to r j of r dash dr dash. So by using the rule of product differentiation of product of two functions you can easily differentiate it. So see here, if we will take the factor 0 to r j r dash dr then we will differentiate 1 over r. And so the first term will be minus mu naught over r square, because differentiation of 1 over r will be 1 by minus 1 by r square. And into the second factor is 0 to integral 0 to r j r dash dr dash. Now we will keep the factor 1 over r at each and we will differentiate this integral part. And you know the when we will differentiate this, what will be this? This will be plus mu naught over r into j of r into r. And so this r and r will cancel. Actually, the differential operator will cancel this integral operator. So this is the result. And so our result is mu naught minus mu naught over r square into integral 0 to r j r dash dr dash plus mu naught into j of r. Now you can see this equation 2 where b of r has been defined from Ampere circuital law, and you can see that this first term can, by the use of equation 2, can be written as what? This can be written as minus 1 over r into b of r, because b of r, you can see this is mu naught by r into integral of this much. So by using equation 2 we can write this derivative del b by del r as, so using equation 2 what you can write? You can write that this del b by del r is equal to minus 1 over r into b of r plus mu naught into j of r. Here our aim is to find this j of r, because you will see that we will be needed the value of this j of r in later calculation. So let us find the value of j of r from here. So you can see that this mu naught into j of r will be what? This is actually equal to del b by del r plus b of r by r. And so you can see that this j of r is equal to what? This will be 1 over mu naught del b by del r plus b of r over mu naught times r. Let us say this is equation 2. So we have calculated using the Ampere circuital law the current density at a distance r. You can see that this actually depends on r. So we have written j as a function of r. Now, as I have told you, the magnetic force acts on the streaming particle, and the expression for the magnetic force per unit volume we have just written above. This is j cross b. So you can now find the magnetic force acting on the streaming particles. So the magnetic force, per unit volume, is, you know, this force is given as what? This is F equal to J cross B. And as you know, this force is actually in radially inward direction. So, and actually the angle between this vector J and B is 90 degree. And so this is actually minus J of R into B of R into R hat. Actually, R hat is a unit vector in radially outward direction, but this force is in radially inward direction. So I have taken here this minus sign. This minus sign actually shows that this force is acting in radially inward direction. So if we want to write the expression for the magnitude of this force, so mod of this force will be what? This is in fact F, and this F will be equal to simply J of R into B of R. J of R into B of R. Let us say this is equation 3. Now you can see the expression for the magnetic force acting on unit volume contains J of R. And we have already calculated using the Ampere circuital law the expression for J of R. So now let us use the value of this J of R from equation 2 in this equation 3. So let us substitute the value of J of R. So using equation 2 in 3, you can see what will be the expression for F. See here, F is J of R times B of R. So, and J of R is this much. And so you can write, we will take here, actually when we will take even the magnitude of this force, we consider here minus sign, just indicating that this force is in the decreasing direction of R. So we take the minus sign here persistent. So let us write the expression for J of R from equation 2 in this equation 3. And you can see simply this RHS of equation 2 will be multiplied by B of R. And so what will be the result? The result will be F equal to minus 1 over 1 over mu naught, 1 over mu naught B into del B by del R, and minus 1 over mu naught into R into B square. This is the force acting on unit volume, and you know this minus sign actually shows that this force is acting in the radially inward direction, that is opposite to the unit vector R cap. Let us say this is equation 4. Now this force you know this force is just acting in inward direction and this will be just equivalent to a pressure. So if we want to express this force in terms of the equivalent pressure, so if the equivalent pressure is denoted by P dash, what will be this F? In fact, in a spherical polar coordinate or in general, you can write the expression for the pressure equivalent to this force acting on unit volume. So in terms of equivalent pressure, let us say P prime, we can write the force acting on unit volume is in fact given as negative gradient of the equivalent pressure. And since you can see that this F only depends on R, so the expression for this gradient of P dashed will be simply equal to del P dashed by R, del R, because it is independent of theta and phi, and so the expression minus del P prime will be simply equal to minus del P prime by del R. Now you can see that we have defined already this force F in equation 4, and here we have defined this force in terms of the equivalent pressure. So definitely we can equate these two equations. So let us equate equation 4 and 5. Equating 4 and 5. So you can see that this minus del P prime by del R will be equal to this much. So neglecting the minus sign as it is, as it will be present in both sides, so we can write that del P prime by del R will be equal to 1 over mu naught B into del B by del R plus B square over mu naught into R. So you can see if we want to find this pressure P dashed, definitely we have to integrate this equation with respect to R. So now let us integrate this equation with respect to R, and so integrating with respect to R, you can see this will be just integral of dP, and this will be equal to integral 0 to R, B square over mu naught R dr, and plus integral 0 to B. Here I am taking the limit B, assuming that at a distance R, B is equal to B, because in this term the integration will be with respect to in fact B. So this is 1 over mu naught B dB. Here I have assumed that B is equal to B at R equal to R, and it is zero at r equal to zero. So the corresponding limits are zero to b, and you can see from here that this is in fact dp dashed. So you can see that p dashed will be equal to what? In fact, let us see the second integral first. This will be simply b square over 2. And so this is b square over 2 mu naught and plus. Now see the first integral. Here 1 over mu naught is a constant factor, and this is integral 0 to r b square over r dr. Actually, in this second integral, the actual value of the integral can be found only when we know what is the relation between b and r. That is, when we will know that b as a function of r, only then we can calculate this integral. But here there is no need to find that relation. So this is our final result. Let us say this is equation 5. Now you know that plasma is a conducting fluid, and as it is a conducting fluid, so its conductivity is very high. And since its conductivity is very high, you know the magnetic lines of force do not penetrate appreciably into a conducting medium. So definitely the magnetic field lines will not penetrate into this plasma column, and so that the magnetic field will be present only outside of this column. And so when we will talk about the region inside this column, then definitely magnetic field in that region will be actually zero. So you can see that the integral in this equation 5, contains no contribution from the discharge region from 0 to r. And this implies actually that inside the discharge, pressure is almost zero. And so the equivalent pressure at the boundary, and when you say boundary, it means this R is equal to capital R, where capital R is actually the radius of the cylindrical column. So in fact, at this boundary, we can find the value of this P prime by taking the value of this integral to be zero. So let us write this important facts which I have just stated here in brief for your convenience, that you know plasma is a conducting fluid. And with high conductivity, and if its conductivity is high, as I have told you, that the penetration of the magnetic line of force will be not to an appreciable depth in it, penetration of magnetic lines of force in it, and so that the integral in this equation 5 contains no contribution from the discharge region from 0 to r. And this implies that this integral 0 to r from b square over r dr, this will be actually equal to 0. And this implies that the pressure inside the column is zero. So pressure inside the column is almost zero, not strictly zero, but almost zero. And so you can say that the pressure at the boundary, that is a boundary column, where in fact R will be equal to capital R, where capital R is the radius of the cylindrical column. So the equivalent pressure at the boundary of the column, when you say boundary of the column, it means this small r is equal to capital R. What will be this? This will be in fact P prime equal to, you can see this equation number 5, that as this term is almost zero, so the pressure will be simply equal to B square over 2 mu naught. See here, this B is at in fact R equal to capital R. Actually, this pressure is denoted by the symbol PM, and it is known as magnetic pressure. This is called magnetic pressure. Why it is called magnetic pressure? You can see that actually the expression for this pressure is, clearly shows that this pressure depends only on the magnetic field, and so it is called magnetic pressure. And as you have seen that inside this column the pressure is zero, and at the boundary pressure is P prime, and this P prime is equal to this much. So this due to this pressure acting in inward direction, the plasma column is actually squeezed or pinched, and this is the region of pinching of the streaming particle, and this is the pressure, the P dashed, or you can say the magnetic pressure B square by 2 mu naught. This pressure is actually acting in inward direction because the pressure inside the column is zero, so definitely this pressure will act in inward direction, because pressure always acts, you know that force always acts from higher pressure to lower pressure. And so due to this, the plasma particle get squeezed or pinched. And so you can see, as the pressure inside is zero, so column is pinched. So I hope you have understand why this pinching effect takes place. The reason is this magnetic pressure developed, and there is almost zero pressure inside the column, and due to this pressure this pinching actually takes place. Now the conclusion drawn is that the pinch effect is the result of sudden buildup of magnetic pressure in the region external to the discharge. You have seen this development of magnetic pressure is actually the region of the pinch effect. So squeezing will continue till the magnetic pressure in the external region is equal to the fluid pressure in the discharge. As you know, the as the squeezing will take place, then inside this region actually the fluid pressure will increase. And when this fluid pressure increases and becomes equal to the magnetic pressure acting in inward direction, then actually balance will be created. And so when the fluid pressure balances the magnetic pressure, then squeezing is stopped until it is not equal to the magnetic pressure, and then squeezing takes place progressively. So squeezing stops when the plasma fluid pressure balances the magnetic pressure then in fact this squeezing of the particle gets stopped. So now in fact our aim is to find what amount of the discharge current is needed for this pinch effect. And for the calculation of this discharge current required for the pinch effect, we will treat the plasma as a perfect fluid, or you can say a perfect gas. And using this is just an ideal situation, or you for simplicity of calculation we treat the plasma fluid as a perfect gas. And using the equation of a state of a perfect gas, we can find the expression or the value for the discharge current needed for the pinch effect. So now our aim is to find the pinch current. As I have told you, for finding the pinch current, we will treat the plasma fluid as a perfect gas. So now plasma fluid is treated as a perfect gas. And you know what is the equation of a state of a perfect gas. In fact, equation of a state of a perfect gas is written in different form. We will actually write here one of the forms of the state of equation of a state of a perfect gas. So equation of a state is given as, one of the forms of the equation of a state of a perfect gas is P equal to nKT. You know what is this n here? N is actually number of particles per unit volume. And K, this is in fact Boltzmann constant, which is a universal constant, you know it. This is Boltzmann constant. And T is the absolute temperature. T is absolute temperature. Now we can write that at the final radius r of the discharge, what will be the expression for the magnetic pressure. We have already seen here that the When R is equal to R, then pressure is actually B square over 2 mu naught. In fact, this expression for pressure is when R is equal to R. So now let us equate these two values of pressure. So at R equal to R, we have pressure, the value of pressure at R equal to R, you have seen that this is in fact B square at R equal to R by 2 mu naught, and this is equal to nkt. Now you can see that when R is equal to R, what is the magnetic field? In fact, according to Biot-Sebald law, you can write the expression for this magnetic field at R equal to R. In fact, this is equal to mu naught I over 2 pi R. Mu naught I over 2 pi R. So this I is actually the current which produces this magnetic field. Actually here this is discharge current, and our aim is to find the value of this discharge current I. So now let us substitute the value of this B of R in this expression. So you can write here that this is 1 over 2 mu naught into B square. And so B is equal to this much. So what will be this? What will be its square? This will be mu naught square I square over 4 pi square R square. And this is equal to nkt. So one of the mu naught will cancel here. And so you can write this equation in this manner. So this is 1 over 2 mu naught I square over 4 pi square R square equal to nkt. And as I have told you, this I is the current in the discharge. And this expression for the current I can be, we can write the expression for I from this equation. So if we find the value of I square, what will be this I square? You can see from here. This will be in fact 2 into mu naught over 4 pi to the power minus 1. Into pi r square into nkt. Actually, I have written this constant factor mu naught over 4 pi in this form, raising the power minus 1 on it, because you know the value of mu naught over 4 pi is 10 to the power minus 7, which is a standard value. So I have written it in this form. Now you can write this expression as 2 into mu naught over 4 pi to the power minus 1 into a naught into n naught into kt. What I have actually written here, you can see that actually here we have used the symbol a naught n naught for what? Actually this is a naught n naught. This has been written instead of pi r square into n. Actually this pi r square is the area of cross section of the column, and this A naught is also the area of cross section of the column initially before pinching, and this is area of cross section after pinching, and this N naught is the particle density or number of particle per unit volume initially, and this N represents the number of particle in unit volume finally. But actually, the conservation of particle requires that this A naught N naught should be equal to this much. This is actually the conservation of particle. Conservation of particles. As I have told you that this A naught is what? A naught is the initial cross section of the discharge. Initial cross section of the discharge. And as I have told you, this N naught is initial particle density. Initial particle density. That is number of particle per unit volume initially before pinching. And K, as I have told you, this is in fact Boltzmann constant. So in order to achieve the temperature of 10 to the power 8 Kelvin for a thermonuclear reactor. In fact, in thermonuclear reactor, temperature is of the order of 10 to the power 8 Kelvin. So if we are performing this experiment in a thermonuclear reactor, then to achieve the temperature of the order of 10 to the power 8 Kelvin, and let us consider a particular value of A naught and N naught, which is practically used, then we can find a probable value of the discharge current or the pinch current. So let T is of the order of 10 to the power 8 Kelvin, A naught, this is 0.04 meter square. In fact, these are generally accepted value, and in general the density of plasma particle is of the order of 10 to the power 21 particles per meter cube. These are in fact the general values. So if we consider these values, then we can find the discharge current required for the pinch effect. So you can see what will be the value of I square here. See the expression for this I square. This is in fact 2 times of this much into this much. So now let us substitute the values of all the quantities in this equation 6. And then we will find the value of I square. So this will be 2 into, you know, mu naught upon 4 pi is 10 to the power minus 7 and to the power minus 1 into A naught. A naught is 0.04 into N naught. N naught we have assumed 10 to the power 21 and Boltzmann constant, you know, this is 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23, and temperature in thermonuclear reactor is of the order of 10 to the power 8 Kelvin. So if we assume these standard values, then what will be the value of I square? After simplification, you will get that this I square is equal to almost 1.1 into 10 to the power 12 ampere square. And that is, if you want to calculate I, this will be of the order of